This is a Wharfdale stop cylinder letterpress printing press, and it was manufactured around 1850. It became one of the most popular printing presses in England, British Isles, and they were still in operation right up into the 70s. I worked one in 1970 in Mount Salis Press, printing bookwork. They were used for newspapers, for books. This particular press came from the Nina Guardian, and it's a fascinating piece of equipment that still works absolutely very, very well. It was donated to the museum by Pat Ryan from the Nina Guardian, and we renovated this machine a few years ago, and as you can see from the prints here, we very successfully printed replica copies of the Proclamation for 1916. The machine is called a stop cylinder machine because when you feed the sheet of paper in, the carriage is moving up and down underneath the running boards here, and when it goes for the impression stroke, the cylinder turns. Get the impression stroke, the type bed goes further on in then to be inked up, and as it's coming back, the cylinder has stopped to allow the type bed go back up to the end to start the stroke all over again. The operator then would feed in a sheet into the lathe on impression, and boom, and then the delivery would take it away. Myself and two friends, former colleagues from the printing, also retired, Billy Ryan and Alf McCormick, whose photograph is here beside me, who passed away a few weeks ago. We decided in 2015 to commemorate the achievement of the compositors and the printer who produced the 1916 Proclamation. We had a letterpress plate made and we set up the machine. We got great support from the industry, from our friends in the industry, as regards helping us out with mechanics, paper, ink, the printing plates and so forth. And on the day of the centenary, 23rd of April 2016, to the hour of when the original was printed, we printed on very, very special paper, a numbered special edition. And on the 23rd of April, the whole museum was packed out with people, with the descendants of the people who actually produced the original Proclamation, and also our families. And it was a very, very emotional day with so many, many people here. The machine ran perfectly without a bother, which we couldn't believe. And it went very successful. Maybe the machine ran perfectly because of the crowd and the adoration that it got. Because for an old machine from 1860, this machine here is still in operation. It is possibly the only Wharfdale that I'm aware of that's operational here in the country.